Hello guys, welcome to Electrical Gadget YouTube channel. My name is Srikant Vetar. Today we will discuss very important and interesting topic which is mostly asked in interview, why the rating of transformer specified in terms of KVA. So let's see. While all other electrical appliances are specified in terms of watts or kilowatts, but the transformer specified in terms of KVA. Why is it so? Let's see. Normal answer people use for this question is, in the transformer, core losses are proportional to voltage and copper losses are proportional to current. For all losses responsible for temperature rise is core losses and copper losses are due to voltage and current. Hence, the transformer is specified in terms of VA or KVA or MVA. To understand this concept, we have drawn a simple diagram here in which we have transformer and load. The load is connected to the transformer. The most uncertain and unpredictable thing in this power diagram is load. No one can expect what kind of load is going to be connected to the transformer. So let me consider a specific load. So load demand is 400 kilowatt at 1 kilo volt. If you notice that load is specified in kilowatt because load is how much work that equipment will do. So the load is always specified in kilowatt. If we consider the load has unity power factor to deliver such amount of power, it will draw 400 amperes of current that will deliver 400 kilowatt power, because the product of these three, 1 kilovolt unity power factor and 400 ampere current, is 400 kilowatt. What if the load has 0.5 power factor? To deliver such amount of power, it will draw 800 amperes of current. The product of these three will be also 400 kilowatt. And what if the load has power factor of 0.25? To deliver such amount of power, it will draw 2000 ampere of current. So during manufacturing the transformer, the manufacturer doesn't know the power factor of the load. So he specifies the specific current and voltage rating of the winding. 1 kilovolt, 400 ampere. I am talking about secondary winding. Product of these two will be 400 kVA. Okay. Imagine that the manufacturer has, instead of giving this rating on the nameplate of the transformer, he has given 400 kilowatt rating on the nameplate of the transformer. So we will see what will happen in this case. If the load is operating at unity power factor, the load will demand 400 amperes of current. This will be in limit. Okay. If the load is operating at 0.5 power factor, the load will demand 800 ampere current. This will be more than the limit of the secondary winding. If the load operating at 0.25 power factor, the load will demand 2000 ampere current. It will be too much than the limit of secondary winding. In such condition, secondary winding of the transformer will damage instantly. In such condition, the manufacturer will be in trouble. So, to be in safe side and avoid such complications, manufacturer always gives rating of the transformer in KVA or in MVA. Okay. The question comes in mind, why only transformer? Why not generator or alternator? Generator or alternator also doesn't know the value of power factor of the load. That's why the generator or alternator also specified in terms of KVA or MVA. Okay. I hope guys you are enjoying our videos. Do not forget to like, share and subscribe our channel. Thank you. If you are missing something, then told it us in our comment section. We will definitely try to cover it in our next session. Thank you.